his own rendition of what it means to be a comic in Philadelphia and how he has been supporting the community and the things that he's been doing to help this event here tonight. So if we will, by a round of applause as he come out, let's welcome our own, Philadelphia's own, Ronnie Law. Now from Philly, West Philly, yeah, I mean, he did West Philly the house. I need to ride home, but I've been waiting outside. West Philly, Philly in general is like, this is the land of the Muslims. It's like the land of the fake Muslims, though, is it? People don't become Muslim until after they get convicted in court. You understand that? Brother walked into the courtroom, Jerome Miller. The cop gave him 25 to 30, he walked out, Walid Akbar Muhammad. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Because Philly style is different, right? West Philly guys got the walk. West Philly guys, this is West Philly guys got that. Yeah! North Philly guys got the rhythm. Where's North Philly? North Philly guys, North Philly. Okay. Hold on to your portion of Long Beach. North Philly is in the building. Hold on to your portion. We have some fun with North Philly. North Philly guys got the rhythm when they talk. You ever see North Philly guys? They don't get that thing twisted, all right, boy? Don't get it twisted, all right, boy? Don't get it. My name is Raheem Akbar Muhammad. Don't get it twisted. And what part of North Philly from? What part of North? Diamond Street? Where? Just yell it out. That's cool. Because I've been in Philly all my life, and I'm finding out the neighborhoods, the names of the neighborhoods in Philly are kind of like the opposite of what the neighborhood is like. The neighborhood, the name of the neighborhoods are the opposite of what they like. Like, I got shot in Nicetown. Old City looks new to me. Germantown is a bunch of Africans. And Fishtown smells like poop. What's going on? And I come from a bad neighborhood too. But down the bottom, how many of you know about the bottom? Let's put it out. Woo! Woo! The neighborhood so bad, I see one guy out there robbing himself. You had a crack here, sold me a DVD. He said, this is rush hour. Gave $10. I went home, put it in, it was a videotape of backed up traffic. I said, you got me. Took him to court and I lost. The rest of the judge said, look like Rush Hour to me.
Fuck.
If Biggie Smalls didn't die, would Jay-Z be where he is today? All right, clap if you think Jay-Z would still be the man if Biggie didn't die. Clap if you think ain't no way in heck Biggie would have been off, he would have been off here. I love chicken soup, but he got some big lips, big lips. He can whisper in his own ear. It's the rock, it's your lips.
Fuck.
80s, the light skin used to rule. Light skin, but I don't think light skin. Let me ask the ladies. How many ladies would prefer, I'm gonna put two kinds of guys. Y'all let me know what y'all prefer. How many get ladies here like that tall, light skinned, thin mustache, curly hair guy? A woman like that prefer that tall black African guy named Rodundo. I can think that, I know it. Cause I like chocolate women, I love chocolate girls. I love me a black Serena Williams chocolate, dark. I want a girl so black, if she open up her eyes real wide and smile, she like the number 3 or the domino. That's what I'm talking about.
Fuck.
Before I continue, like I said, my name is Ron Long, and I'm trying to do this comedy thing. Hopefully one day, I did HBO with Chris Rock. Hopefully one day I get on David Letterman. If not, I'll be on America's Most Wanted. Either way, we'll give me a TV credit. So I'm gonna make it upstairs, man, because I'm broke. And I get mad because these rappers be rich and mad. Why are you mad and you rich? I don't get that. 50 Cent, I got shot 9 times. You're making $20 million a movie. I'm doing the laugh house for free. I should be mad. So that's why I'm telling you, I'm doing this comedy thing. I had to get me a regular job, so I do got to. I work at the Wachovia Bank on Broad Street. I usually got a ski mask on. I work it, but work is work. I'm lazy. Look at that woman. I'm lazy. I am lazy. Look at that. I'm lazy. I am not no 9 to 5 guy. I'll give you a 3 to 3:30. I wake up to take a nap. Can you sleep. I can do overtime with that, trust me. Before I continue, I want to say please support the vendors and please continue to support. Let's give Latoya a round of applause for the final touch hours. She's been doing her business. I like that. I love supporting black businesses. If I can find one that's opened up on time, I love to support them. Because you know you go to black business or like a, you go there and they got that little sign, be back in 20 minutes. Come back in 20 minutes, be back in an hour. Come back in an hour, be closed for the day, come back tomorrow.
Fuck.
Yeah, but before I wrap, I want to say on a real tip, man, before I forget, please continue to support. I want to thank y'all for giving yourselves a round of applause for supporting this. For real, Sickle Cells is a serious thing. For real, I'm saying, you got a lot of those all about me and joking around. It's a serious cause, and I want to thank y'all for supporting this. For real, man, because like it's a real serious thing. I want to thank the speaker, your rap prof, the speaker here today, for going to speak. Please, I want y'all to visit me on my website too. My email is comedyset@yahoo.com. Comedyset, like ready, set, go. Please visit my website. I want to thank Latoya Brown. Thank you, everybody. Please, everybody, for running along. Good night. Thank you very much, y'all. Good night. Peace.
Black guy step up. This is for my people. Grab the white guy, threw him on the ground.